I'd like to introduce a new product that I'm very excited to bring to the whitetail world. It's called High Oil Corn, made by Partner Brand Seed, and I'm going to be their main distributor in their wildlife division. Now, standard corn, which this here is, and you can see the difference in the color, and I'm going to explain what it is. Standard corn only has 3.5% oil. This over here, the new high oil corn, was basically made for ethanol, and this has 12% oil. The other thing is, this high oil corn has more trace minerals than this ear here. The thing is, they grow 90 different test plots on their test plots for over 30 years. And guess what happened? The deer all go to the high oil corn every time to eat. So the deer prefer this. It gives them more fat. This here doesn't have half the fat content that this does. This is right around 12% fat content. What that does is make the deer be able to get through the winter better. It gives oil to their hair, which makes them hold thermal cold, help fight off the cold. And then at the same time, it helps with milk production and antler growth. Now, what's also nice about this is this corn is also glyphosate tolerant, just like everybody wants. And we also have Roundup Ready or glyphosate tolerant soybeans. We have now got a new mixture I'm working with, and what we are doing is we're mixing 70% soybeans with 30% of this high oil corn. We put it in a grain drill and we plant it roughly at 1¼ inches depth. When the corn comes up, it is scattered through the whole field, which we're going to see pictures in a little bit. Now what happens, the deer do not detassel the corn because it's not in rows. And what also they won't do is they won't desilk it because it's not in rows. And what the corn does is shade the beans. The beans grow very tender. It makes almost like a velvet leaf. They set tons of pods. The deer prefer the velvet leaves in the spring and summer, so they leave the corn alone, eat the beans, which can take the regrowth and tolerance of being browsed on. And then the beans throw off nitrogen, which the corn can use. So it's a win-win situation. In a few years, nobody will be growing standard corn no more. This is comparable, it's lower priced than standard corn, and it does so much more for the wildlife and the deer. Here we are at the Whitetail Habitat Research Center, and I'm showing you our new mixture and how I've been planting corn for several years. And this is the difference in high oil corn. Now remember, I talked about planting the corn 30% high oil corn with 70% beans. I mixed the seed up, planted at 1¼ inches, and look at all the pods. And because the corn shades the beans, they get extremely tall, okay? And they set a lot of pods. Then, because they're not in rows, the deer don't detassel it and they don't desilk it. And I get quality ears on these, and they, of course, have consumed all the corn. We're in January here right now talking, and look at what I still have. So now what happened in the summertime, they were browsing on all the leaves because they were great to eat. And then the corn got all cured. Then they came in and ate the corn. And now you'll see there's millions of tracks out here, and the deer are now just starting to consume the soybeans, and they're gonna eat them hard here in January and February. And that's going to get them through the winter beautifully. And they're going to never run out of food because of the different plantings I use. Anyone that's just growing corn is throwing all this tonnage of beans away. Anyone that's growing just beans is throwing all these ears of corn away. You can grow both at the same time in the same thing, and they both help each other. So I highly recommend you checking out our new product. We have it specially blend. You can buy it in a 1-acre bag or a 3-acre bag. All this will be on the website, and prices and all that. And I'll take all the time you want to talk about that if you want to get on there and take a good look at it.